Hello, welcome back to Dr. Simulator. We're talking about the possibility of another possibility with the lion dude. With the lion, tiger, wolf, whatever he wanted to call himself, I don't remember. I think he called himself a lion. No, he didn't call himself a lion, he called himself a cheetah. Or whatever he calls himself. You know, he became involved in the House of Amano, and the two of them made good use of their meetings to plan this little kidnapping. See, I don't like how he keeps talking about, having there being two of them, considering that, what happened between the two of them? No, there's not supposed to be two of them. There's supposed to be three of them. At least if I believe what we believe. Possible, no coincidence, and two of them maybe at the same time, which is the same scenario. I feel like it has something to do with one of these two. Because reunited pair and two of them. Let me get this real quickly. One is a butler and one is the friend of the sun, you mean? They probably thought that was their best shot. Is that what you honestly believe? I mean, like, it makes sense, to be honest. With what he has, it makes sense. What he would say. Press this. You mean how they plotted to commit this crime as blood relatives? Can you think of a better partner? They're certainly a clever pair. Yeah, I don't like how he keeps calling them partners, because there's another partner somewhere around this. No one would ever suspect that they were, in fact, family. Yes, from the very beginning, they painstakingly practiced these roles well. I mean, let me present right here. What do I actually have to prove that? Well, technically I have the stolen costumes. Technically, you can never steal three. If they want to steal two, I mean, not if they want to steal two, but if they wanted to only have like two of them, then they probably would have stolen two. Like, they would probably steal like a blue or proto or something dumb like that. They probably wouldn't have stolen three. I'm gonna say what I say. Yeah! First time for everything! I decided to be smart! Maybe at 10:50 a.m. I'm actually the best at the time. The kidnapping wasn't planned by just two people alone. And what kind of proof do you have of that? Quite simply, there were three kidnappers. Oh, take that! What the heck? You go into that new jiu-jitsu stance! I'm gonna put them up as well! If I have to. Four costumes were stolen from the Wild Wild West area background. We found one of them in the kidnapper's hideout, but as for the other three, we can assume they were being worn by three different people. And we already found one of them, I think. We also found a set of three cups and three folding chairs that were used in the hideout. See, I was looking for that technically, but I couldn't find that, apparently. It was all clearly points to a three-man group. And I believe that this third person is the real mastermind behind the master. He mastered the kidnappings. He planned the kidnappings, even though we have no proof of that whatsoever. I'm ready for anything! Woo! Who is this mastermind? Ah, now we got him. I present to you the brains behind the kidnapping. What? Wait, what? It's a security lady the entire time! Oh no. It's probably one of, like, either one of these two. I'm not quite sure. I'm gonna say Lance only because I like detective dramas that talk about how, like, detective dramas about how, like, the son did it the entire time because he wanted to get back at the dude or something. I don't remember. I'm just gonna choose him. Take that! Slap in the face! Realization right there! The heck is he doing? You go on that day! Yeah, we put him up! You dragon fist us! Yes, this abduction was, in fact, schemed by Lance himself. Recall what he said when he appeared before us. Wait, what? Did you see the faces of your kidnappers? No, I didn't see their faces, but two. One was a... Oh my god, that doesn't make sense! He should have been able to see that! However, there were three kidnappers, which is in direct contradiction to what he said. Oh, I was talking about the woman part, but okay, that works too. But I know I only saw two people. This guy was being held hostage. It's possible he couldn't see all three of them. Ah, yes, about when you were being held. I have my doubts about what happened then. Wait, we do? Lance, would you mind telling us what happened while you were being held captive? I really don't remember much anymore, honest. But I don't tell you. But if I don't tell you at least something, you won't believe me at all, will you? Hey, I like his style already. He didn't put up a grudge at all. Lance's testimony. I was kidnapped yesterday morning. They had me shut in that room, blindfolded the entire time. but the kidnappers suddenly disappeared around the time I heard rain falling outside. All three of them? My hands were cuffed, but it was a stroke of luck that they left me alone. I made my escape and ran away from that room as fast as I could. I don't know what I could possibly say about that. Through the underground passageway— Don't say that! Oh wait, what? Are you okay? Sorry, I really didn't want to recall that horrible ordeal, but... But now you believe me, right? No, not quite yet. Ha ha! Take that! Why do you look at me with the icy daggers in your eyes? Ah, we do that to everybody. How are you not looking at the icy dagger guy with the lion dude? Lion, cheetah, wolf dude! Because he's a prosecutor, and because they're all like that. Hey! You're looking at us with icy glares, there, die, lion, death dude! I'll have you know, Agent Prosecutor, Agent Lang, a prosecutor's eyes are for discerning the truth. And should they be interpreted to be cruel at times, then so be it. There's a sticking point in Lance's testament. There is! Let's see what he offers up when I push a little. Okay, so I'm supposed to press somewhere. Let's see, I was kidnapped yesterday morning. Sure, why not? I haven't shown that room blindfold the entire time. Don't really have any evidence against. Disappeared around the time I heard rain falling outside. I'm gonna press this, because something about it. The kidnappers disappeared? The room fell into a sudden silence. I have been left behind like an unwanted mutt. And what do you mean by unwanted mutt? Ah, because he's never been unwanted before in his life? I don't know. What a pointless question. It's not like he's gonna tell you anything new, you know? Who knows? It's a poetic simile. You should learn how to use them, too. I know how to use them! I'm a writer! Kind of. You may look refined on the outside. But it's no good if you're not refined on the inside as well. I want to learn how to make my hair swirl in the breeze like that. Maybe it's not big enough for that. My hands were cuffed. How'd he, get out? I wonder. Then those cuffs on your wrist, I suppose you are still cuffed in that... Dang! I'm well aware of how I am chained to reality. I don't like this guy's talking now. If I couldn't find a key, so I'm afraid that I'm stuck like this. Even though I escaped from the jail cell, I will forever be a prisoner. I don't like this guy! He talks too poetically. He reminds me of Shakespeare. I made my escape and ran as fast as I possibly could. Alright, let's check that. How did you manage to escape? I wanted to just get out of there, but the door leading outside... Oh, the sword thing. Which is why I had to use the underground passageway to make my escape. I remember our escape to be equally as hard. This is an invaluable piece of testimony. I mustn't let it go unexamined. Wait, what? The door leading outside was locked tight, so I had to use the underground passageway. Wait, when was the, sword... The sword thing? Was there anyone touch the check button? This is what we found in the underground hideout. I don't remember when we found it. But it was the thing that jammed us. One of these, like, guys told us something important. I want to remember, but I don't remember. I'm just gonna... Wait, object? Okay, good. I know it had something to do with the knife, I just don't know what it is. But was it really? Are we really gonna press him because, like, oh, the door was locked, but it looked locked. Did he just get out of those and then re-get into them? I'm pretty sure that's proof that he has the key somewhere in his mouth. Also, I like his mouth. Or face. It's funny. We're talking about that room behind the saloon front, right? Look, I heard that it took quite a few men to get that thing open. Right, Sheena? Wait a minute! That was because of the sword! No! That was inside! Okay. I'm smart. The door was locked from the inside because of the sword. I'm stupid. Stupid counter somewhere around here, because I can't remember stuff. Then take a look at this. What is that? Sword? It's not an especially reliable one if it's broken like that. Allow me to start from the end. My conclusion is that the door was never locked. Yeah, I remember. It should be helpful. Yeah! It just didn't have the handle. He should have been able to get inside. Outside, I mean. Even though your hands were cuffed together, you could still use them. If that's the case, then why did you not just simply remove the sword and escape? Why didn't I? I was disoriented. Okay, that's... So you decide to open the thing that's harder to open than just escape. Yes, that's it. I didn't notice it. As if I should expect such a bold-faced lie. The face of the bold blowed. You locked yourself in that room because you had to make yourself look like the victim. But you did not, in fact, possess the key to the door. Wait, what? That is why you used the prop sword to improvise and create a prison of your very own. Yeah! Not so fast! That's all I'm supposed to be happy about. You've been making this guy out to be one of the kidnappers for some time now. I wonder if you've forgotten something very important along the way. And what would that be? A motive! What else? Money? I would say so. Do you honestly think that an upright, pure boy like him... I highly doubt he's pure. Would hatch up a completely pointless scheme such as a kidnapping himself? Objection! You really don't know rich people, do you? This proves that Lance did indeed have a motive to commit the crime. Wait, what? Was it this? Wait a minute! It's Hunter Lender! The loan company! Loan sharks! Loan sharks are the reason why kidnappings happen! Wow, that was a sick burn on loan sharks. To put it simply, Lance is a very urgent need for money. This is hardly your typical love letter. It is in fact a collections bill. Why would they call it like this, though? It appears our upstanding boy has accumulated quite a debt. Isn't that right, Lance? Ha! You flipped those handcuffs! Looks like it's hard being the son of a rich man, too. It must be rough when you have to resort to stealing from your old man, huh? Oh, dang. The thief is calling you a thief! What do you say about that? Alright, I give up. I abducted myself. Lance. Okay, but I thought you would know. It's over, Lolly. In this life, we really are bound by our fates after all. I hate this poetic justice thing! All I wanted was to go with you to a new town, somewhere where no one would know us. I wanted us to be well off with $1 million, but now, that dream is over. Aww. Oh, Lance. Then you're giving yourself up? Yes. I hardly plan to run away from this world with my Lolly. Oh, planned. Never mind. Oliver even helped us with the plan, but then he had to go and stab us in the back. I really doubt he stabbed you guys, though. He turned on you? Maybe he didn't want to split the ransom money. That's my guess. It happened almost right after you made the drop-off. Wait, then who hit us with the sword? When we were alone, he attacked me all of a sudden. After a brief struggle, I was able to contain him and keep him under control. Wait, then who killed him? He left him inside the room as Lolly and I made our escape. We wore different costumes and split up. Lolly left first in a blue badger costume. I'm still wondering who the heck was that blue badger person we just found, like, literally inside the kidnapper's hideout. That would mean the person Officer Meekin saw was Miss Pops. But right then, the old man had just had to wake up. I was careless and he tackled me pretty hard from behind. Then Oliver put on a bad badger costume, took the suitcase with $1 million and ran. But he's dead! I contacted Lolly right away and warned her that he had a gun. They had no idea that they were related, so I thought that it could only end badly. Wait, how'd you know then? I still don't believe it! That person is not my father! Okay, we get it! You don't have to put the knife so closely to your neck! Because if he was, I just killed my own father! Dang. She's still in this? Then it really was you? Why are we still doing part of that? Why do we still believe that she did it? I'm starting to truly disbelieve this at all other points. That man was not my father because at the stadium, there was a bad badger pulling the suitcase with the $1 million in it. But that badger pointed his gun at me, aiming to shoot me dead. Aww. That's why I used the gun that I got from Lance. There was a gunshot. The other person crumpled to the ground and I ran, scared for my life. Aww. Gunshot! I think the big picture is finally coming into focus, don't you? Lolly, forgive me. I didn't think it would turn out to something so frightening. Gunshot! If only I could have protected you. So, Miss Pops, she shot her own dad without even knowing who he really was? I really doubt this! If what she says is true, are you saying she's lying? But why would she lie about something like that? What purpose could it serve? You'll be surprised how often people lie without even realizing it themselves, Kay. Huh? What's that supposed to mean? What I mean is, listen very carefully to her confession once more and you'll see. Okay, we'll do that next episode. So next episode, we're gonna see what the heck Pops is lying about, which I don't even know, but I have something about the gunshots! So yeah, it's Neon362 signing off.